to our top story. For more on the Labor Department's target to put a stop to ENDO, we now have on the line Secretary Silvestre Bello. Good to have you with us, Secretary. Thank you so much for joining us.
Ati, good afternoon.
Yes, so Secretary Bello, first off, has your team been able to take a full accounting of just how big a number are those affected by ENDO?
Ati, can you speak slowly?
Sure.
So that's your question, yes.
Have you been able to take a full accounting of how big a number are those affected by ENDO?
Right now, we are in that process, Kate, you know. We have a two-day seminar of all the regional directors of the Department of Labor and Employment, and we are looking into the problem of ENDO and contractualization. With the end in view, of completely eliminating ENDO and contractualization of the employment industry.
And I know that you gave a timeline here when you spoke to ECOP last week. You're planning to reduce ENDO by 50% this year and the remaining 50% by next year.
That is true, KP, that's true. It's a very tall order that you will try our best to accomplish.
Yeah, but you know, some legitimate contractors, such as those representing PALSCON, whom I just spoke with this morning, Butch Guerrero and Roda Caliwara, say it's a tall order, Secretary, because the timing is too quick. Quick removal of ENDO in the system would impact a million jobs of legitimate contractors. So how do we address that?
Well, actually, KK, we are aware of the enormity of our job. But I have asked my regional directors if they can achieve our target of 50% reduction for this year and another 50% reduction for next year. And they all stood up to the challenge. So hopefully we will be able to meet our target of reducing and then eventually eliminating ENDO and contractualization. Of course, with the help of both labor and management, especially from PALSCON.
But how do you intend to ensure, sir, that the safety nets in the interim are created to ensure that there is no negative impact on the legitimate contractors themselves, those who pay benefits, those apart from ENDO who do not?
Yes, Katie, we are conscious of that. And that is the reason why I told you that we will be in constant consultation with both management and the labor. We don't want to create a war between our laborers and our managers. We have to impress on them that in business, there are two partners, and one is from the labor and one from management. They should consider themselves as allies and partners. So we hope that we will not be, creating a bigger problem, bigger than ENDO and bigger than contractualization.
And which sectors have you identified as the first to get ENDO contractors removed? Because as we know, it's retail and manufacturing as the biggest in the services sector here.
Well, the biggest factor here is the legitimate and effective implementation of our existing labor laws. We have labor laws that govern the relationship between management and labor. And we have to strictly enforce this. If we do that, then we are solving already one of the problems.
And I presume this includes RA 18-A, because this is most important.
Yes.
What do you intend to do to ensure that this is effectively implemented?
As you said, Katie, RA 18-A will also be reviewed. Some sectors are asking for its abolition. Some are saying improvise. So we will continue to consult management and labor on how to fix this 18A.
Okay, well, appreciate the time. Secretary Bello, thank you so much for the interview there. Secretary Bello of the Labor and Employment Department joining us live.